Hello, everyone. Welcome to a special episode of Hypovolemia with Arturio Emerys. So what I've done here is I've recreated my game world in a creative world. And the reason I wanted to do that is because I've been recording episodes for quite a while. And I finally figured out how to do something that I should have been able to do around episode 3 or 4. So I wanted to do a special episode to kind of explain how that works. And I want to do it without spoiling the stuff that I've done in my Let's Play world. So I'm just going to do a little creative world here to show you how to do this. So I'm going to gather up a few things. Blood rune. And this doesn't have to be a whole great big altar thing. I just need to have a basic altar. To demonstrate how this works. Now, I'm going to assume that you already know how to make all this stuff from either my episode or somebody else's episode. These are not hard to do. I need 2 of these. Diviners. So there are fairly early quests that ask you to make these. Didn't I just get chests out? I must have put them away without actually using them. And once I get this all set up, we'll explain it all. Okay. Nope. There we go. All right. Bear with me, folks. Almost ready. Okay, so what we have here, I'm going to do one other thing. Portable tank with life essence. There we go. Now, once you get a pump built, you basically just put one of these on top of your altar. And with the piping that works with the pumps, you just connect it right there and it'll feed blood automatically into your altar. In fact, you know what? I could even show that. I mean, we're here. It's in a creative world. Why not? Dynamo. There's a quest where you have to make 2 blood dynamos. So. Oh, wait, that wasn't what I was trying to do. So you make one and you get one as a reward. And there's a pump, and we'll need some mechanical pipe, and we'll need some of the universal. Okay, just do a little planning here, figure out how to set this up. So this is a life, well, technically it's a blood ocean. All right, so if we, nope. Electric pump. These can be kind of tricky to set up because you have to, yeah, there we go. Power goes there, the blood comes out here. So the mechanical pipe is how you get the blood out. And the universal cable is for power. a second here, almost set. And I'm trying, come on, work with me here. I'm trying to do this quickly, which is almost always my downfall. Okay, there we go. So now, almost set. Oh wait, I need levers. I don't need that, I don't need that, I don't need that. Now I do need to feed blood to the altars, or to the dynamos. And that's the basic mechanical pipe. All right, now, so this is the setup. You take your two blood dynamos, you have your power coming out, feed that to your pump, and then whatever machines you want to run off of this. Basic mechanical pipe coming from the pump. It has to feed both blood dynamos, and then it has to feed a portable tank on top of your altar. And we will need a some sort of wand. What is that stupid wand called? Ah, yeah, a configurator. And what you do with the configurator is you shift right click, and it should be draining down into the blood altar, but it doesn't seem to be. Okay, give me a second. Portable tank full of blood. All right, let's get rid of that. And let's just get a portable tank that's empty. We'll put that right there. That's connected up. Use the configurator on it. Okay, now that should drain into there. So what we need now is you got to prime these pumps a little bit. You got to produce a little bit of energy. So you can just grab a bucket and just put blood into the dynamos. So there's a little bit of power to the pump. You can see it starting to draw blood. And it's filling up the dynamos. They're producing more and more power. And pump is coming over here, and it is not going into the altar for some reason. Okay. Let me look at this. Let's grab a divination sigil and a sigil of sight, and let's see what's going on here. Okay, it says it's a tier 2 with 1,000 capacity. Why is it not taking? And there's 0 life points into it. Oh, there it goes. All right. It's filling now. 100. It's filling slowly because it doesn't have any speed runes or anything like that. All right, let's put these in our inventory, and let's get on with the purpose of this demonstration. Let's get some splinters. We'll get a whole stack of those. And let's get some skulls. And some stone. Now, we do have to finish configuring all of this just a little bit. So what we have here is we have a blood altar. We've got blood runes, 8 blood runes, turning this into a tier 2 altar. We have diviners on either side. Over here we have a couple of these item translocators. And over here we have a logistical sorter and a chest for each one. Now, these item translocators, by right-clicking, you change the configuration of them. Okay? When it's pointed out like that, it means it's pulling from this chest. When it's pushed in like that, it means it's pushing in here. This logistical sorter by turning auto eject on, anything that comes into the diviner here will get forced into this chest. So in theory, if we put those wooden splinters there, what'll happen is they're automatically getting thrown into this diviner. They're automatically going through the altar. And when all of them are done, they should be getting ejected. Auto eject on. Why is that? That might be facing the wrong way. Let's try that again. Yeah, it's facing the wrong way. Okay. And then auto eject on. Yep. Okay, so this is the setup. This is how you make it work. This is how you set up your pump to pump blood into your altar automatically. This is how you set up your diviners. This is how you set up the item translocators, and this is how you set up the logistical sorters to automate your blood altar. Now, for me, I didn't figure out how to do this until either episode 13 or 14. So you're not going to see this for a while. And once I finally figured this out, I decided this was important enough that if you're going to play Hypovolemia, you need to know how to do this early, because you can do this early, very, very early in the game. And I just had trouble finding how to do this. Smash Keys and his girlfriend, Porphyra, they did this in one of their videos, and I've been watching them off and on, but I just missed the part where they showed how to do this. So this is how you do it. And there's only 16 there. And I'm not really sure why. There's splinters there. I can tell you, when you get a bigger altar, when you get some of the acceleration runes and augmented capacity runes and all that kind of stuff, this actually works really well. Like, you can put a stack of splinters in there, and almost instantly it'll convert them into wood planks. If you put an entire stack of stone in there, it will slowly convert them into whatever slates you need to make your blood altar. And you're limited by whatever tier altar you have. So, but it'll do it. It took about an hour to do an entire stack of stone on my tier 4 altar in my normal game world. So that's what I wanted to show everybody. I hope that explains a lot. This alone, these two things here, the pump and this automation system here, these two things will make your life so much better in Hypovolemia. This takes a lot of the grindiness out of it. The only other thing that you really can't avoid grindiness-wise is the seeds. When you are improving seeds, there's not a good way to automate it. There are ways to speed it up using the sigil of the Green Grove. But other than that, you have to do that work. You just have to spend the time doing it. So this is Arturio Emerys with a special episode of Hypovolemia, focusing on the translocators, logistical sorters, and the pumps for early game automation. I hope you got something out of it. I hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a like or a comment if you did. I'd love it if you would subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. And I will see you next time. Arturio Emerys signing out.